In this video, we will show you the very basics of the DeepSpar Disk Imager 4 hardware and software combination. What is being shown right now is the first screen we see after entering the application. At this point, the source drive is actually turned off, so we need to press F11 to turn it on, so let's do that. As soon as we do that, we can see at the top left corner that the ATA status registers are starting to come on, so right now the drive is busy as it's still spinning up. Now it is finished, so it is ready to be worked with. Because the drive is now ready, we can rescan our ATA channels and confirm that the source and destination drives identify correctly and that they are the ones we would like to work with. So, after that's all confirmed, we just have to press OK and we can start working on those drives. An important note is that we are showing the default algorithms of the DeepSpar Disk Imager. In reality, absolutely everything can be changed to suit the drive being imaged in order to make the imaging process faster and safer. The smart subsystems have already been turned off at this point, and the bad sector allocation is off as well, so we can begin imaging the drive. We're about to image a small section of this degraded drive, so what's going to happen is the imager will run three passes on this section. The first pass will be very light, so whenever any block of sectors takes longer than 0.3 seconds to read, we will send a reset command to the drive to get it to stop doing whatever it's doing and continue on. So here we can see the yellow blocks. They are the ones that were skipped with a reset command, and the green ones are the ones that were read successfully. So, after the first pass is done, now you can see that it's doing the second pass. It's going backwards sector by sector, and it's doing only the blocks that were previously skipped on the first pass. So, we can see that it's getting pretty much everything that was skipped, except for a few bad sectors here and there. Software-based tools cannot skip sectors, so if we were using software to image this drive, instead of being able to skip a sector block after a defined period of time, we would have no choice but to wait the full few seconds for the drive to respond on its own after a failed read. This alone would slow things down considerably and increase stress on the drive, because the heads would be spending a lot more time trying to go after the bad areas, and of course degrade in the process. At this point, we have everything except 4 sectors, or 2 kilobytes of data. If we decide that we really want those 4 sectors, what we can do is launch the third and final imaging pass, which will instruct the DeepSpar Disk Imager to read each one of those bad sectors using commands which ignore correction algorithms. So we can start the process right now. What's happening is that we are reading each one of those bad sectors in this manner 10 times, and we are applying bit-level statistical analysis to the results. So, let's say in 8 reads out of 10, the first bit is a 1, and in 2 reads it's a 0. We're going to assume it's a 1, and we're going to write 1 to the destination hard drive. So this is sort of like an educated guess. In the next segment, we will discuss drive read-write heads. We will talk a bit about head mapping, how it works, and why it is important. So here we have another hard drive, and we can start imaging it just to see how it will go. At the beginning, we have a lot of green, so everything is good. But now we've reached the point where the drive stops reading correctly, so we see that we can't seem to get anything out of the drive, and it takes a long time to respond to reset commands. We see at the bottom that the speed is 0, so we're not getting anything right now. So in this case, to move forward, we can stop imaging, and we can build a head map. And here we just select that we are working with an IBM drive. Right now, the imager is using vendor-specific commands to request from the drive information which tells us which sector belongs to which head. This allows us to test each individual head with the media test function. Here we can see the media test in progress, and it's quite clear that head 0, 1, and 2 are good working heads, but head 3 is completely gone, and we can't read anything from it. So from here on forward, we can simply press OK, and we can go ahead and turn off that head just by unchecking head 3 and starting the imaging process once again. we can see that the imager automatically skips all the sectors that belong to head 3. So, instead of pointlessly trying to retrieve data from head 3, which is not reading at all, we're just leaving it alone and focusing on the working heads. This lets us get decent speed, and we're getting 3/4 of the data off that drive instead of nothing. In this last segment, we will briefly show how imaging by files works on the DeepSpar Disk Imager 4 with the network add-on. So here we see our DeepSpar recovery environment, which is a Windows software suite that comes with the DeepSpar Disk Imager 4. With the use of the network add-on, it is capable of connecting to the DeepSpar Disk Imager over LAN, as we have just done. So the first thing we do is run a file system scan, which images the critical file system elements of the drive. In this particular case, we are dealing with an NTFS file system, so the MFT records are being imaged. The purpose of this process is to let us know which sectors belong to which files, so that when we go to select files, the DeepSpar Disk Imager will know which sectors it needs to go after to retrieve those files. The process has completed, so now we're able to browse through all the files and select whichever ones we need. The fastest way to do this is to run the search function. For this example, let's say we want doc files, so we can input *.doc to instruct the recovery environment software to search through all MFT entries to locate all doc files for us. All doc files have now been selected, and we are ready to start imaging them. What is happening right now is that the DeepSpar recovery environment is telling the disk imager over LAN which sectors are needed to recover these files. What the imager is going to do is go from LBA0, the start of the drive, until the end of the drive, and it's going to grab only the sectors which are needed for our files. All the algorithms and imaging settings that we have seen previously are being taken into account here as well. Almost all other data recovery tools do imaging file by file. In other words, they will grab every fragment of the first file before moving on to the second file, and so on. Because files are fragmented, this is quite heavy on the drive. The heads have to go back and forth getting every tiny fragment before they can move on. Instead, we do it in a linear fashion, according to the drive. So we start with LBA0, and then we go sequentially until the end, grabbing everything at once. This method of file imaging is much faster and lighter on the drive. Now that the relevant sectors have been imaged from the source to the destination hard drive, all we have to do is simply save the files to our Windows PC. So, what's happening right now is that the recovery environment is reading those files from the healthy destination hard drive, which is still connected to our imager, and transferring them to a local folder over LAN. Here we see it is completed, so we can just verify that we have them. And here are all the doc files we just saved. That's the end of this demo video. Thank you for watching.